Hey guys, Zay from the Infinite Jukebox here with another quick album review, and today I wanted to talk about the new Fall Out Boy record, So Much for Stardust. Seeing Fall Out Boy go from a genuinely unpopular band in music nerd circles to people praying for them to make another album like From Under the Cork Tree after a series of incredibly disastrous post-reunion records has been genuinely comical at times, I won't lie. But it also means that they haven't quite gotten the critical reappraisal of their 2000s emo pop-punk brethren, My Chemical Romance, nor have they been as retroactively despised as Panic at the Disco. So Much for Stardust is meant to be the sort of comeback album for Fall Out Boy in the eyes of both the critics and their older fans, as the singles of this record attracted a lot of people who enjoyed their pre-reunion, pre-breakup sound, including myself. At its best, So Much for Stardust is just as good as anything that you would find on an original run Fall Out Boy album. Sure, tracks like The Kintsugi Kid and Love from the Other Side are not musical genius by any means, but what they are is well-performed, emo-influenced pop-punk-slash-rock songs that are genuinely fun and also well-executed instrumentally. So Much for Stardust is not without its flaws, however. For example, tracks like Fake Out and I Am My Own Muse just sort of hint at the sickeningly clean sound of some of their post-reunion records like Save Rock and Roll, which, if you are familiar with, is a big not good, to say the least. While the production of the record done by longtime collaborator Neil Avron is meant to inspire some sense of nostalgia, considering he worked with the band on some of their earliest releases, but unfortunately it just comes across as so polished that the band's energy doesn't make the same impact that it would in a more raw environment. As a whole, this record sees Fall Out Boy make a successful comeback after the laughably bad MANIA, one of the worst albums made by any major band in the past few years. And although the semi-departure-slash-hiatus of longtime guitarist Joe Trohman leaves things feeling a bit uncertain as to what the band's future will be, we can at least now confidently say that Fall Out Boy are no longer terrible. For the time being, at least. Who knows what's next? I'm going to give this record 3 stars out of 5. And with that being said, that's the end of this quick review. I've been Zane from the Infinite Jukebox. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.